Good morning, students. Today I am here to explain you one of the important parts of grammar, parts of speech. First, there are 8 parts of speech. They are displayed here: noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, conjunctions, prepositions, and interjections. We will understand each one of them one by one, so pay utmost attention. First, parts of speech: noun. What is a noun? Noun, it is a naming word. It means name of person, place, thing, or any kinds of feeling. The word for person, name, thing, feelings, it is a noun. For example, we talk about the name of place: India, Australia, Bharuj, Anand, Ahmedabad. These are the name of places. Name of persons: Akash, Jetvi. The persons' names, they are also part of noun. Various things: ball, chair, table. These are name of things. Feelings: honesty, that is, we can say, one kind of noun. So remember, a naming word, that is a noun, it means name of a person, place, or thing, or feelings. That is the first part of speech, noun. We move ahead. Second part of speech, that is pronoun. If we see here, in the word pronoun, one word is noun. Remember, pronoun, it means a word that replaces a noun. In other words, a word which is used in place of a noun, it is called a pronoun. For example, Akash is a good boy. He always helps others. In this sentence, he, it stands for Akash. So it is an example of pronoun. Any word which replaces a noun, it is called a pronoun. We move to third parts of speech, that is adjective. It is also related with noun and pronoun. Adjective, it is a word that modifies a noun or pronoun. A word that tells something about noun or pronoun. In the previous parts of speech, pronoun, I have given you example that Akash is a good boy. He helps others. In this sentence, Akash is a good boy. In that sentence, there are two nouns, Akash and boy. And good, it tells something more about Akash. So good, it is an adjective. So any word that modifies a noun or pronoun, in other words, a word that tells something more about noun or pronoun, it is called an adjective. Then next, verb. Verb, it is an action word. A word that shows action in the sentence, it is called a verb. I am repeating, a word that shows action in a sentence, it is a verb. For example, I am teaching you. In this sentence, teaching, it shows action. Which action is done by the subject? That is teaching. In this sentence, I am teaching you. In this sentence, the action word is teaching. So teaching, it is a verb. Cooking, playing, sitting, reading, studying, all these words, they show action, so they are called verb. I hope you have understood. We move to the next, that is adverb. If you see here, it is also one word is there, verb, and before that, add. A word that adds something, a word that adds something to the verb, that is known as adverb. In other words, a word that modifies a verb, adjective or another adverb, that is called an adverb. For example, he wrote the answers correctly. He wrote the answers correctly. In this sentence, correctly, it tells something about the verb, how the action is done, and we got the answer correctly. So that correctly, it is an adverb, and that tells something about verb. Adverb, it also modifies an adjective. Now, already we studied adjective, that a word that modifies a noun or pronoun. He is very happy. In that sentence, happy, it is adjective, but this adjective is modified by word very. So very, it is also an adverb because it tells something about adjective. Now we move to the another, that is another adverb. A word that modifies another adverb, it is also called an adverb. That is also like adjective. He wrote very nicely all the answers. In that sentence, nicely, very, they are modifying the adverb. So it is also called adverb. So this is our fifth part of speech, adverb. I repeat, adverb, it is a word that modifies a verb, adjective or another adverb. Next parts of speech, that is conjunctions. Conjunctions, they are joining words. They join two words, clauses, phrases, even some of the times sentences. Whenever the word joining two nouns, pronouns, sentences, clauses and phrases, that is known as conjunctions. Next comes preposition. Prepositions are words they use to relate a noun or pronoun to another part of the sentence. This is when we read the definition, when we read the meaning of preposition, somehow it is confusing. But if you see the word preposition, it is made of two words, positions and prefix pre. Pre, it means before. So the words which used to show the positions, they are known as prepositions. For example, he is sitting in the chair. Here that in, that shows position, so it is a preposition. The pen is on the table, so the on, it is a preposition because it shows the position of a thing. So preposition, it is word that used to relate a noun or pronoun to another part of the sentence. There are many prepositions we have been using in our daily life. We have to remember that the words which relate noun or pronoun to another part of the sentence. And the last one, that is interjections. Interjections, they are the words expressing feelings. Many of the times when we have different types of feelings, some words automatically comes from our mouth, like ouch, alas, hooray. These are the words which express feelings. Such words in English, they are called interjections. They are only the words ouch, alas, hooray, oh. These are the words which express feelings. So these words expressing feelings, they are called interjections. So remember, there are eight parts of speech: noun, pronoun, adjective, verb, adverb, conjunctions, prepositions and interjections. In the next video, we can have examples, and by examples we can see that how we can identify that which parts of speech is used in the sentence. We will continue in the next video by having the examples. Thank you.